Hey everybody, it's Angela, Molson352, and I'm back with another process video. Again, I have got yet another picture of my granddaughter, and I'm just having a great time scrapping all these photos, all these little girl photos, and all the colors and stuff that are in kids' photos. And so I love this one. She's just to a point where she can hold her head up by herself. And so her mama sat her in this little chair and she could hold her head up and she was just having the greatest time. And I have backed it on this kind of teal colored pattern paper to bring out the teal in the little chair she's sitting in. And then I'm going to do the whole layout on this white wood grain paper. And it didn't have the manufacturer strip still on it. I think I cut it off because I was going to do another layout with it and then I didn't. And so I don't know whose paper this is. I'm sorry about that. And I decided I wanted to put a little extra color on it. So I pulled out some of my stencils. And these are from Sawcrafters. And I have these little ink pads that I get in my Scraptastic kits. So I decide to go ahead and use those. I do a little test on the color there. And this first Sawcrafters stencil is a 4x4 floral. And I love the florals. I seem to get a lot of use out of the florals that I have of hers. And I'm just putting pink for the flowers and then green for the leaves. And you'll see in the photo again when I bring it back that the little pad in the crib, I don't know if they still call that a bumper or not, or whatever, but in the crib has some florals that are kind of shabby chic with the teal and the pinks. And that's kind of how my daughter has decorated the nursery. And so I was just going to bring out a little more of this pink and green floral pattern from that. And so I'm just doing it in three places around the layout. And my photo is going to go in the middle there. I kind of marked it before I started doing the stencils so I would know where they would show out. So I'm just cleaning that stencil off. Then I grab another Sawcrafter stencil, and this might be a 6x6 stencil, I don't know. I tested that blue there in the middle where I knew it would be covered up, and I just didn't like it. It was too vibrant. So I'm just sticking with the pink and green. This stencil is Saw's like a paint splatter, and then it has like coffee rings on it. And I'm just using the paint splatter portion of it and just putting that in a few places as well. And I'm not putting the whole thing. I'm just giving hints, you know, of color and splatter on there. So now I'm going to do some of those splatters also in the green ink. And I'm kind of overlapping some of them a little bit, shading some parts of it heavier than others. I'm using the foam applicator instead of just taking the ink pad direct because it gives it a little softer feel. And then I'm also letting some of the splatter just kind of go right off the edge of the page. So I clean that stencil up, and then I have one more of Saw's stencils that I'm going to use, and it's this little 4x4 heart stencil. So I just take my pink ink, and I'm going, and I'm just putting a couple scattered here and there. So they're really subtle, but they add that little extra touch, a little bit of extra dimension. So I just put those in a few places around the layout as well. So it was good to get the stencils out and use those. So I go ahead and put my inks aside there for the moment and bring my photo back in. And I just laugh every time I see this photo. I mean, she's just having a great old time there. And this is some stuff out of my last Scraptastic kit. Just kind of looking through to see if there's anything I can use on this particular layout. And I like the pink doily. And I thought it was just one. And you'll see later when I go to glue it on, I find out there's actually two there. So There was some Heidi swap words I thought I might use on here, so I pulled out the word smile, and I also cut this tag off, and I don't think those make it on there, but you know, I was just pulling out stuff that I thought might work. So I set that aside, and I find that I really do want the doily, so I cut it in half, and at this point I don't realize there's two, so I do salvage the other one, although it is in two pieces, but I usually wind up cutting them in half anyway. So I go ahead and use that same green ink just to edge the mat around the photo, and then I go ahead and kind of position where I want the doilies to be. And it just gives a little extra feminine touch, brings that pink and kind of, you know, puts a buffer between the white and the matte. So the blue of that flare badge and stuff just wasn't quite working. So I pulled out this fresh cut that I got these little frames for like 99 cents at Tuesday Morning the other day. And so I'm looking at this kind of aqua colored frame, so I decide to cut it out. I'm not sure at this point if I'm going to use it or not, so I want to leave it on the clear backing. And I really like how that makes the photo pop. But my photo's a little bit bigger than that frame, so I would need to trim it down. So I go ahead and trim this side. And then I have to trim off some of the other so I can get the image centered in there. But I do wind up having to pull it all the way off to finish cutting and recentering it. But luckily my adhesive, even though it was permanent, it hadn't been adhered very long, so it came up with no problem. So this frame flops around a little bit, so you kind of have to fiddle with it to get it on there just right. But it's kind of a puffy, plasticky kind of frame. And I just love that color of teal on there. So the smile, the color of the smile, the green on there isn't quite right. So I'm thinking of using a pink word that's in here, and it says pretty. And then I think, well, it could be just pretty smile could be my title. So I'm thinking about that, although the colors don't match exactly. Here's where I find out there's actually two. So I take that other one off and put it to use later. So I go ahead and put my photo down so I can start doing some other layering and stuff. And I'm liking that. I'm not too sure about the title still. And I do want to use those little pink corners on there, but I decide to do some other layering first. I look at this cut apart sheet, and I like the word love, and I like the pink and green version of it. I'm thinking that might work, so I go ahead and cut those off. But they just don't, I don't know, they just don't fit in there very well. They just look too clunky or chunky or something. So I set those aside, and I'm thinking, okay, what else am I going to use on here? So I start looking around my desk, and I pull these layered hearts and butterflies that have been sitting on my desk forever. I have those little crocheted flowers, but I used those, I think, on the last layout I did of her, or a couple layouts ago. And I have some felt bows. And I've been trying to use these layered things forever, and they almost get on here, and then I wind up pulling them back off. So it was a good try, almost, but not quite. They're so cute and I want to use them. They're just not working on the layouts that I do. So I keep pulling them back off and going with something else. So at this point, I pull the heart off and I leave the butterflies, but I do wind up pulling the butterflies off later. So I look at these bows, but they're just a little bit too big for the scale of this layout. So I keep rummaging through the stuff on my desk. These bows, you know, I've been using these things up on quite a few layouts, but the colors, I'm down to some colors that, you know, are really distinct and saturated, and it's going to take a special layout for those. So I look in my Saw Crafters stuff. There's that bunny that I made for a different layout, but I didn't use that. I find some of her little butterflies and I look at the bird, but then decide against it. So I like the butterflies, so it looks like I'm kind of going with a butterfly theme. And then I find this word adorable and I figure I can ink it the colors that I used on the background. And so I put these two Heidi Swap words away because they just weren't quite the right color. And adorable really fits the photo. So I decide to go ahead and use that and use these two butterflies and then use the same color of ink I used for the stencil so that way everything will match in. So I do a quick test on the scrap piece to see which of the colors I want to do the title in. And I decide to do it in the pink so it'll stand out a little more. And then I use both the pink and the green on the butterflies and make two different colors of butterflies. So I just go ahead and put a coat of ink on there, and I do wind up putting a couple coats on there to get it to, you know, really cover well because it wants to absorb into the MDF a little bit. So I just dry that real quick with my heat gun. Then I go ahead and put another coat on there. And so that's the right scale. I can make it the exact color I want, and it's the right sentiment. So I've got that little box, that little drawer there. It's one of Sawcrafter's organization drawers. It's the 9-drawer unit, and it has the little dividers. And so I put all my little stuff from her in there. That one happens to be the drawer that has more like sentiments and stuff in it. And then I have another one that has winged things, another one that's like beach, one that's baby, and one that's like nature or something. I don't know. I filled up the whole 9-drawer unit with little MDF and chipboard pieces. So I'm just drying up the butterflies, and I colored those with the Prima ink as well. So I'm liking that better. And now I know I just need some more layering. I need some more paper elements. So I had got these Kaiser Craft. I think this is like the chai tea die cut pack, and I'd gotten them when they were on sale at Cherry on Top a while ago. And so I liked the colors of, you know, kind of soft blues, teals, pinks in there, and they also had quite a few butterflies. So I thought I'd stay with that. And there go those two layered butterflies. So like I said, they almost made it on this layout, but not quite. So once I decided to go with this die cut pack, the colors on those butterflies just didn't quite go. So I'm just looking for some pieces that I can tuck behind. I don't want to cover up my stenciling and stuff. I just need a few things that will go under the mat and over the mat and kind of ground everything and pull it together. So I'm just kind of pulling out a bunch of things I think will work out of this pack. And I like the roses. I didn't want too much of the green of some of the roses because the green wasn't quite right, but a little bit of green on the leaves of the other ones was fine. So I have adorable, and I'm thinking about putting adorable, and then there was a little thing that said smile, but I just went with adorable in the end because my husband walked in and I said, "Do you think I should put smile under here?" And he goes, "No, she's just adorable." So not that he's biased or anything. I think he's talking to me right now. That's why my hands are doing other things sometimes. And so I'm looking to layer a few things underneath that title word to kind of give that a place to sit. And then I'm looking to sprinkle a few more of the butterflies around. So it's just kind of a, you know, keep placing, keep rearranging until you find something you like. And sometimes that can be tedious and sometimes it can be fun. On this one, I was just enjoying myself having a conversation with my hubby and kind of just playing around with it. And it's great, you know, now that she, you know, is laughing so much. And I love the technology that my stepdaughter sends me pictures pretty much every day or video. And yeah, so that's the fun part of all the social media is being able to, you know, really be a part, even though if you can't, you know, visit right then, you're kind of there still every day. So the baby gets a little older, maybe I'll have to Skype, even though she's, you know, just a couple cities away. I can drive there. It's, you know, it's a little bit of a drive, but it's not too bad. It's probably about an hour to go over to her house. But, you know, during the week when you work late and stuff, you don't necessarily get to see them. And so now I'm going to go ahead and start gluing the items down because I'm really liking this. The butterflies are kind of flying up. And I've got a mixture of the paper butterflies and the MDF butterflies. So I point that one down so it kind of leads your eye into the page. And then I have some of the others. I think most of the others are fluttering up. So I go ahead and I use just some Scotch quick dry adhesive on those MDF pieces to get those to stick down. And I'm just using my paintbrush to kind of push them down really good. Because the ink is still somewhat tacky on top. That Prima ink, that chalk ink, takes a little while to dry. So I like to kind of leave it alone. And then I put down the title. And I've kind of got everything touching something else. You know, each butterfly kind of slightly touches another, or it touches the mat, or it touches another flower. So everything is kind of connected. And so now I go ahead and I pull up these pink kind of photo corners that were with the Fresh Cut collection. And I put the three there, and then because the adorable is kind of in the way, I put the other one at the bottom of the word adorable, just kind of brackets it in. And then I'm looking for, I wanted to put an enamel heart in the middle of the adorable, the heart that's in adorable. So I'm just kind of looking through my stash to see if I have one that'll work. And I find two of them there. One of them's a little bit bigger and pink, that one there, and the other one's smaller and blue, but I decide to go with the pink one. And it just gives a little extra touch to the MDF there. And so at this point, I think I'm pretty much done, but I decide I want to back it on some cardstock. So I go ahead and trim a couple sides off on this. And then under the word adorable on that tag, I'll write her name and the date the photo was taken. I have to look up exactly what day she took that photo, but I'll journal under the title. This will be one for her baby album. So I'm just going to mat it on this pink stock, and it really kind of pulls everything together. So I just go and put some adhesive on there, center it up, and I really love how this turned out. It's just soft and, you know, it's got that kind of vintagey feel. You can see the butterflies, my stenciling, the little MDF butterflies to give a little height and texture. And that is my completed layout. So thank you guys so much for watching. And if you have any questions or anything, just leave me a comment below and I'll talk to you later. Bye.